Alright, I'm gonna throw some manure on the other plants, shovel this back in.
Here's my little strawberries. Aren't they cute? We'll see what they do. That's the strawberries. These are the blueberries. This is the garden. Tomatoes, cauliflower, broccoli, cabbage, and one lonely eggplant. And that over there is our new cherry bush. And of course, those are the beans back there in the pot. That's it.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O, and on this farm he had a dog, E-I-E-I-O, with a here, there, here, there, everywhere. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. Now old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O, and on this farm he had a cow, E-I-E-I-O, with a here.
They said it wasn't working, they needed a hand. So women got together to do what they can. We need to change the species, they executed a plan. Women now created stay-at-home man. The stay-at-home man.
The stay-at-home man.
He's a stay-at-home man.
He's a stay-at-home man.
Oh, you don't know.
Nope.
Why, today is Aunt Gail's birthday. Why, she's 21.
Right.
So, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Aunt Gail. Happy birthday to you!
Woo!
Love you. Bye-bye. Okay, so here we are, and it doesn't really matter where I am, because you can see by the way I'm dressed. I really shouldn't be where I am, but I am here anyway. So anyway, make things short, my mom's here.
Hi, Mom!
Hi!
And her ride home has left. So right now, it really sucks being her, but me, being the hero I am, we'll save her. I will take her to my sister's house.
Up there.
We don't know why she's here and she's not taking Mom home, because Mom always liked me best and they torture her like this. Oh yeah, so anyway, I forgot. I said, why don't you come up to my house, you know, and we could visit Fairyland and you could see how Fairyland is. And she says, my niece says,
no! Grandma's got to come and see the gorilla in the zoo turn one.
So my mother goes, oh yeah, I'm going to that. And I said, so you'd rather go see a monkey turn one than to visit your son?
A gorilla.
Okay, so I know you all still want to. Oh, it's a gorilla monkey. Okay, big monkey. All right, so there we go. Just another reason why you all want to be me, I know. Later. Bye now. What?
Oh. People. Come on. He likes people. Come on.
Did you have?
Come on. What are you doing, Mom? What? Oh, what? Oh, Mommy, I have to see you too. Mommy. Mommy. Oh. Oh. Oh, you're not supposed to jump. No jumping, Mom.
Yes. Okay.
Oh, no.
He can come and jump.
Calm down.
Calm down. Calm down. All right.
Yeah,
calm down. All right. All right. Okay.
Oh,
okay.
He's cute. What do you doing?
This is what he does. He
gets
in the morning. He wakes up.
Oh, you're a girl dog.
Okay. Oh, you're a good fella. Good fella, you're a good boy.
I came home. Yes, yeah, I came home. Yes. Okay. All right.
Okay, Mommy, I'm coming.
All right, come on. I'm home.
All right, come on, buddy. Let's hit the highway.
Yeah, are we going somewhere?
Okay, so it's Saturday afternoon, and I decided to, seeing as we're right down by the seed place, to I guess some new seeds to grow here, try. So I kind of dug up a little patch here in front of the house. All the weeds out and everything. And I decided it'd be nice if we had like giant sunflowers out front here. So we got some sunflowers in there. Guaranteed to grow. So you know what that means. To me, that sounds like a challenge. And I love challenges when it comes to seeds and stuff. So let's open this up and see what we got. Oh, Mook, how you doing? Oh, yeah, a little bit working hard towing the garden. Oh, there's a Moby. Say hello to everyone, puppies. Ooh, give me kisses. Okay. All right. Now, for $1.99, they are so generous that they give you 6 seeds. Goodbye, Mrs. Stay-at-home Man.
Goodbye, Mr. Stay-at-home Man.
6 sunflower seeds. But remember, they're guaranteed to grow. So, Mook, gotta stay out of the camera when I'm doing this. Now, I don't care how much you love me, Papa. You cannot. You can't.
Aw, Grandpa.
Not when I'm doing TV. You can't be loving me like this.
No. Look at her loving you like crazy.
She wants to go take a nap. That's what she thinks it's time to do. I know. I know her.
Way,
I know
Grandpa.
Her. So anyway, I'll put them in here. All right. I hope that's a good shot for you. Looks pretty good. So, let's see here. Guess we can go. 1, 2. Plenty wet. Damn, I did it! Yeah. So, we'll just have to see how these are going. And I have my little pile of transplant grass here, see? So I gotta find some home for that. And, I don't know, probably might putter around here a little more. So there's the sunflower seeds, and today is June 9th. So we'll see how they're doing. Hopefully it'll look cute. I didn't realize I was only gonna get 6 because I had to put more in. I don't know. All right. Sunflowers, cool. Goodbye. Okay, so this is a little different. I'm out in the truck with neighbor Joe. Now, today's little problem here is Ellen needs some shelving. So we're off for one of neighbor Joe's buddies who owns a garage down here in Glenary. Right, Glenary? Yeah. And we're gonna see if he can cut these bars for me from this set of shelving that I got from a certain worldwide distributing store that we're I just happened to somehow get them without anybody knowing I had them, and that's a big secret, and I really shouldn't be putting this on TV, but that's okay, because none of you will say anything, I understand, so we're going to go see if he wants to be on TV. So here we are with neighbor Joe, and we're off. Okay, here we are, and as always, things run. Neighbor Joe's making a phone call to see where he is. Oh, doesn't seem to be around. Another successful. Well, yeah, in my case it is. This is how things go. All right. So anyway, I don't know. He's going to leave a note, and we'll keep you posted on does Ellen get shelves today or not. So hang on. We'll be back. Yeah.
You drop the hydraulics, it drags fucking sparks. It blows sparks all over the place.
And this is where we're going.
Already done that.
All right. We're going right. Well, it's a little bit later, Sunday afternoon. And neighbor Joe found the, I don't know what we call him, Sparky. I don't know. But, you know, he, like Joe was saying, does hydraulics and crazy stuff on cars. He's only 19 and said he could chop this off. So we'll see, right? How's your day been? All right, so here we go. We'll get down here and see where he is.
How old are you?
17.
He's 17.
You forgot his name, right? Me, right? Okay.
I want to be left out.
Hi, Spencer.
Good, how are you?
Yeah, we'll see if you can take care of this. My wife will be indebted to you forever, and so will I. So I hear you do like all kinds of crazy stuff to cars.
Yeah, custom body work.
At what? 17, huh?
Yeah.
I used to do this stuff when I was 17.
Airbag trucks, hydro them. Just fun stuff. That's Ernie.
Is this your student? Oh, you're not like the sensei, and he's like the turtle.
Yeah. We just work on custom trucks. We do the firewall on this one, the airbag, raise frame, reset the firewall for the motor. The motor for it's work 283.
Motorheads, yeah. My brother'd like this. He was a motorhead. I do a lot of body work, only because I'm too cheap to pay for it. Now, one of these is bent. And I'm just wondering, if it can't be straightened out without breaking, I brought another one. Because I can just use that set in the garage and not worry about it. But if you want to give it a heave-ho. So he's lived in Glasgow? Oh. I just moved here. Here comes the big question. You see my shelf? Nah, he doesn't have it. Nobody watches my show. Oh, do you have Channel 23? All right, well, that's good then, because now you'll be on it.
I have satellite.
What? Oh, now all of a sudden, neighbor Joe's camera shot. All right. Yeah, that's stainless steel, I think. Oh, yeah, yes, a family show would like to see that. We'll show the children how not to grow up. Call you Paris pretty soon. You like that one, eh?
All right, let's get
it. Hey, that was all right. And now you want to cut off on the X.
On the X, this line closest to the X.
Right, the two in between I want to keep. And if you'll notice, they actually have numbers on there.
There's okay, yeah.
And we want to cut off 65 because I need 64 inches.
So this margin's getting cut, right?
Right. You want to keep the black. You want to keep the black box. Cut the X off.
Cut it right here.
No, cut it here.
Cut it there. Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Hey, oh, it's spark time. We'll be right back.
Oh, that's all right. Dude, I give that a 10. That was cool.
Grind it down after.
One's gonna have no marking on it. The one that doesn't have marking will throw back in the truck. You only need 4. Thank you very much. Your garage?
I rent it from Joe Grimaldi.
Oh, really? You rent it?
Yeah.
Boy, you're doing all right for yourself at 17.
Yeah, I work for them during the day.
No school? Graduated? Yeah. No, no special certificate even?
No, I'm going to do that at night.
But soon?
Yeah.
Because you know, it doesn't matter how good you are. Amen.
They both got the, you know, they're both good. You careful. It's fun to work with them. I like it. Very cool. It's always something different too. It's not like we're doing the same thing every day. That's the best part of that. Oh, the little Black Ranger? Yeah, we were dragging it last night at the car show.
Oh, is that you running around in the little black pickup?
Yeah, I did put it together with one of my friends.
My wife thinks you're pretty funny. Well, no. She was wondering why you were running around with your exhaust system dragging. And I said, I don't think so.
Hey.
I said, I don't think they're like dragging their exhaust system. I think there's a little more there.
Yeah, I put hydraulics in it. So he's been dragging it every day he can.
Going to Stewart's.
Yeah, I'm going to start dragging it.
You made a wheel up already?
Okay, so he's gonna like grind these up so like Ellen doesn't slit her hands open on it. And are you gonna help me put these together? Yeah? Alright, and maybe we can get neighbor Joe in the basement. He's a little shorter than I am, so it's easier. And We'll come down and visit again. You wanna say bye? I guess you can't hear me. Hold on a minute. Wanna say bye?
Bye.
All right, see you later.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to your face! Happy birthday to you!
Hey, happy birthday! Happy birthday to you! Hey, happy birthday! Happy birthday to you!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! Oh, happy, happy, happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday to you!
To you all!
Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy! Happy birthday! Happy!
Oh, good morning.
I walked through a county courthouse square. On a park bench, an old man was sitting there.
Open it up for me.
I said, your old courthouse is kind of run down. He said, no, it'll do for our little town. I said, your old flagpole has leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it. He said, have a seat. And I sat down. Is this the first time you've been to our little town? I said, I think it is. He said, I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key sat watching it write and say, can you see? And it got a bad rip in New Orleans with Pakenham and Jackson tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on though. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, and she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, and refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. Cause she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, we take her down every night, we don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her upright. On second thought, I do like to brag, cause I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Music is my life. I think it's a gift from God that my voice, you know, and I just want to be able to share that with everyone, share my music, share my feelings, and hopefully touch people in a way that that only music can do.
Love you too.